Hey guys, welcome, welcome. We'll get started shortly here. Welcome everyone, we'll get started shortly here. Hello everyone, we'll get started shortly. Hello everyone, welcome, welcome. We'll get started shortly. Welcome guys, hope you're having a great week. Welcome, welcome. Welcome guys, welcome, welcome. Welcome guys, welcome, welcome. Welcome guys, we'll get started shortly. Hey Lamar, welcome. We'll get started shortly.
says summer. More like a carefree afternoon picnic. And there's no picnic food more versatile than Vasa crisp breads. Whether you're piling on charcuterie favorites like cured meats, cheeses, and preserves, or making vegetarian...
Hey guys, welcome. We'll get started shortly. Welcome, welcome. We'll get started shortly. Hope everyone's having a great week. We'll get started shortly here. All right. Let's go ahead and get started here. Hopefully you guys can see my screen here. It says trend following. As you guys know, this evening we're going to go over trading in the zone. Okay, trading in the zone and your mindset. I'm going to share a different screen here and then come back to trend following. One second here. Just hold on for me. All right. So you guys should see the screen here. It says trading in the zone. I highly recommend this book. It's perhaps one of the best books written on your mindset when it comes to trading. All right, so highly recommend this book, Trading in the Zone. There's also a free audio book on YouTube. All right, so you can go on YouTube, do a search for Trading in the Zone. The author is Mark Douglas. All right, and I would highly recommend this book. When we do one-on-one coaching with our traders, we use this book as a guideline, okay? So we use this book as a guideline. We're not gonna go too long tonight. We're gonna go probably about 30 minutes. All right, I'm gonna go through some principles here, and then you stop me if you guys have any questions at all. All right, so I'm gonna go back to trend following. All right, usually when we talk about trading in the zone, it's usually about your mindset. But I want to go over something a bit differently tonight. So. Tonight, what I want to talk about is this other book here, Trend Following, and how this relates to trading in the zone. All right. So you guys should see my shared screen here. Do you guys see my shared screen? Do you see that? Do you guys see my shared screen? Let me know if you see my shared screen. It should say trend following. You guys see that? Yep. All right. Awesome. Awesome. All right. So Trend Following by Michael Koval. Okay. So how to make a fortune in bull, bear, and black swan markets. Okay. This book we give to our traders who purchase any of our trading systems. And all our systems are based on the principles here in Trend Following, okay? So Trend Following by Michael Koval. The reason this is important is because a lot of our mindset, okay? A lot of the work that we do with our mindset goes along with Trend Following, all right? So I'm gonna repeat that. A lot of the work that we do with our mindset, and when it comes to trading in the zone, has a lot to do with trend following and staying in the trend. So think of the term trend following. So we want to be following the trend. We want to be staying in the trend. Okay, again, how to make a fortune in bull, bear, and black swan markets, okay? Black swan market is kind of like the coronavirus, right? That's something that's unexpected. That just kind of happens. All right. So I'm going to show you guys what I mean by tying in you're trading in the zone to trend following. All right, so I'm gonna share my screen here. And now you should see the trading screen. So you guys should see our trading screen here. All right, so let's go over this. So normally when we look at trading in the zone, it's all about your mindset, all right? But what I want to go over this evening is a bit different, all right? And I want to show you guys how you can implement, all right? You can implement trading in the zone, all right? Kind of like your trend following, all right? So we still want to use our mindset, right? We want to be very focused on the trade that's in front of us. We don't, you know, limit our emotions and all of that, right? But what I want to show you guys are trends. So when we look at that book, Trend Following, all right, we want to follow trends. And the reason why I want to do this is I want to incorporate trading in the zone with trends. All right. So if you guys look here, right? If you guys look here, just over here. All right. Do you guys see anything? Do you see anything in particular happening here?
Hello?
Yeah, can you guys see anything in particular happening here on this chart right here, this side right here?
Oh Lord, she's on going on that thing.
All right. Do you see anything in particular happening here? Anyone?
Some of the top ones are turning into downtrends.
So some of the top ones up here in this area here?
Yeah, it looks like they're turning red. So they're heading towards the downtrend.
They're heading red. Okay. Anything else? Anything else you guys see there?
The certain currency pairs are all moving in the same direction.
Certain currency pairs are all moving in the same direction. Like which one, for example?
Which group? Your screen is very small, but I think that's, I can't tell. Like up one more. Yeah, there. What pairs are those?
These are the dollar pairs.
So the dollar pairs, the majority of them are on a downtrend.
Okay, very good. Very good. So follow me for a second, guys. Follow me for a second. All right. Trading in the zone is not all about your mindset, right? Trading in the zone, okay, we can also apply that to the way the currency pairs. And we'll just take, it could be stocks, cryptos, whatever, right? But they also get in the zone. Okay, listen, the pairs, all these pairs here, these are over 40 currency pairs. They also get in the zone. Okay, so they can get out of the zone and they can get in the zone. How would they get out of the zone? How would they, let's say, not be in the zone as far as the Forex pairs here? Now, this is a bit different thinking than what we've talked about in the past.
Can you ask that question again, Dave?
Okay. So we have all of the currency pairs here. Okay. So these here are moving down, right? These here are moving down. These are moving kind of up, right? These are kind of mixed. How could these pairs here, just looking at this radar here, right? And think about the zone. And what I'm normally when we talk about trading in the zone, and you guys have your book, right? Trading in the zone, which is really about mindset and the principles, how we trade, right? So it's a game of math and all of that. Okay, but this evening I want you guys to think of things a bit differently, right? So it's not just about us, right? It's also about the market. So if you guys look here, right here, is there anything? Now, Stella, you mentioned that these are all going down, right? Okay, all going down. So would you guys say that these pairs here are in a zone or out of the zone? Are they in a zone or out of the zone?
So I'd say they're in a zone.
Okay, they're in a zone. Why are they in a zone?
Because if I remember from trading in the zone, you want to trade in the direction of the market. And so if the market is, I don't know whether to call it the momentum or the trend, if it's headed down, then you don't want to be going in the opposite direction.
Very good. Very good. So the momentum, the trend, right? So the momentum, the trend is in the down, is moving down. So downward, the markdown phase, right? So the trend is down, momentum is down. All right. We only have one here that's neutral. All the other pairs within the dollar pairs, the dollar group, they're in the zone. All right. They're in the zone. All right. So I want you guys to think about this. This is something we don't talk about a lot, right? Okay, we always talk about, hey, we have to be in the zone, right? We have to be in the zone. You know, we have to have the right mindset and all of that. But guess what? The market has to be in the zone also. All right, think about that. Think about that, right? The market has to be in a zone also. I mean, so think about, we can do everything we can, right? To get ourselves, in the zone, right? So we can do everything. We can be focused. We have our plan, right? And guess what? The market might not be in the zone. What would happen? Give me an example here of these pairs here not being in the zone. So out of all of these groups here, so we've got the Aussie group, the Kiwi group, the New Zealand group, the yen group, the dollar, the euro, pound, and then we've got cryptos down here. So if these pairs here, right, are in the zone, we can say that these are in the zone, right? 90% of these pairs here are all moving to the downside. So yeah, they're in the zone. Is there a group that's not in the zone? Is there a group that's not in the zone?
So those pound, I think the pound pairs, there's five total. Two are blue, two are red, and one's neutral.
Okay.
So they're kind of mixed.
They're mixed. So the pound, dollar, pound, New Zealand, Swiss. So the pound dollar is up. Pound New Zealand is neutral. Pound Swiss is up. Pound CAD is down. And pound Aussie is down. Is this different? Is this different than this? Is it different? And if so, how? Is something happening here different than what's happening here?
What was the other one? Sorry, Dave. Besides the dollar one, what was the other one?
The pound. The pound peers down here. The pound peers down here.
Yeah. If you're talking about the pound, then I would say the pound is on a standstill. It doesn't have a direction. So it's at a standstill. It doesn't have a momentum right now. Like it's not either up or it's not a down. It looks like it's just standing still, the pound.
Okay. So any particular pound pair or the whole group of pound pairs?
Well, if you're looking at it as a whole, mm-hmm. like as a whole, as a group, because you said, you know, they you know, you want to follow the momentum, you want to move the direction they're moving at. The pound right now is not moving as a whole. They're not moving neither direction. Some of them are moving up, some of them are down, and one is neutral.
Okay. So they're somewhat mixed, right? So some are up, some are down, some are neutral. Would you guys say that this is in the zone? The pound pairs are in the zone?
No.
Right? So this is very different from this, right? Very different. So we would say these are in the zone, right? The dollar pairs are in the zone, yes or no?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. And the pound pairs, they're not in the zone, right?
Right.
No, I would say the term for the pound pairs, all the pairs, mm-hmm. they're right now, they volatile right now. So, you know, and I'm not sure, Dave, if they're all, you know, all the pound, you know, the pound, the red, the blue, and the neutral. If it's like that and they're not in the zone, they're volatile, does that mean that, you know, if you pick one pair just mm-hmm. to trade, they, you know, they might go either direction. It's hard to read them. It gets more difficult.
Very good. Very good. Very good. So it's hard to read. Okay. So it's hard to read, right? There's no real direction, right? Very different. These five pairs here are very different pound pairs. Very different from this. So we would say these pairs here are in the zone. These pairs are not in the zone. Okay. And I want you guys to just think with me here for a bit. All right. These pairs here are not in the zone. They're not consistent. They don't have a trend. They're not trending or moving in one direction. They're like, they have no idea what they're doing, right? They don't know if they want to go up. They don't know if they want to go down. They don't know if they want to stay neutral, right? So they're all over the place. Kind of like these pairs here, very, very different. They've made up their mind, right? They've made up their mind. Guess what? 90% of them are moving to the downside. We only have one here that's like on the fence, but guess what? I'm sure that the others here can convince this one last standing pair here, dollar Swiss, right, to go to the downside. So these pairs here are in the zone. These pairs here are not. These pairs here are in the zone. These pairs here are not in the zone. These pairs here are in the zone. And why is this important? Why do you guys think this is important? What I'm explaining here, what I'm trying to get across to you guys here. Why am I focusing on this process here? Because it's not something that we talk about a lot, right? When we talk about trading in the zone, it's really us, right? We're just looking at, hey, we need to be in the zone, right? So we're in the driver's seat, right? We need to keep our emotions in check, right? We need to buy when our signal says buy, sell when our signal says sell. Okay, so why am I pointing this out? Why am I talking about this here. What do you guys think?
Because we want to point out the trend. You want to be in the zone and you also want to be following the trend. Therefore, you're working in one direction.
Very good. Very good, Daniel. Very good. All right. So guess what, guys? Yes, we have to be in the zone. We've got to have the right mindset, right? When we get to our trading desk, we start taking trades, right? We've got to flush out all the negative thoughts and all of that, right? The market has to do the same thing. Right? The market has to kind of clear a path. Right? It's got to decide, hey, am I going to go down? Right? Am I going to go up? Or guess what? Am I undecided right now? So what's cool, the cool thing for us to do as traders, right, is to spot where the market is in the zone. Right? So it's not just us who has to be in the zone. The market has to be in the zone also, right? So the market, the dollar pairs right now, they're in the zone. And guess what? If we are in the zone, guess what? We have a better chance, right, of being successful. What would happen here if we spend all this time building the right mindset, getting ready, but guess what? We try to trade these pairs here that's somewhat mixed. What might happen? What might happen with our trading?
Mixed. We the market could go in any direction.
Okay.
We just, not that we have certainty, but it could turn on us.
It could turn on us, right? Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And what else could it do? What else could it do? Could the market being like this, could it throw us off our zone? Could it throw us off our zone? Right, with all of this indecision here, right? With all this indecision here, that could throw us off, right? So we could have everything, right, lined up, right? We could be, everything's lined up, everything's perfect, right? We've got everything ready to go, and we go to trade, and guess what? We trade in pairs here that there's no decision here. So we could be ready as much as we want, but guess what? The market isn't ready. All right. So this is just a little exercise that I want you guys to try. Yes, we want to be in the zone, right? You want to do everything you can to get yourself ready, right? Have your checklist of the things that you need to do before you take the trade. But guess what? The market has to be ready too. All right? The market has to be ready. All right? And when we tie in the market with our, you know, with us being in the zone, then guess what? We have a much better chance, and we are flowing with the market. Our mindset is ready and makes trading a much easier. Okay, that makes sense. Here is an example of an area. And we talked about this last night. So right now, and I like picking on pound yen. It is my favorite pair to trade. When it's moving though, when it's moving, if it's consolidating, then it's not. But if you guys look here, so we're gonna do this here. And just follow me here. And just follow me here. All right. Okay. So from here to here, there's our buy signal here. There was our sell signal here. Buy signal here, sell signal here. Price is moving along the moving average all the way up. Okay. Buy signal here, sell signal here. Are we in the zone here? Is price in the zone here?
I would say yes.
You would say yes. Okay. All right. Good. So price is in the zone here. And I just want you guys to think about this. Trading is all about, it's a thinking game. All right. Right here. Here is support, here is resistance. Would you say price is in the zone here?
No.
No? Why do you say that?
It looks indecisive.
Very good. Right, very good. Very good. Very good. How about here? Is price in the zone here or not? Is price in the zone here or not?
No.
No. How about here? Is price in the zone or not?
Yes.
Yeah. Very good. So what I would like you guys to do, right? What I would like you guys to start doing is as you read trading in the zone, as you read trading in the zone, you learn those concepts, right? Tie it to the markets, okay? Tie it to price action, all right? And what we want to do is, so we want to, a lot of times when I tell traders, you know, to read the book and all of that, they really focus on their mindset, and which is good, it's what we want to do. But then, you know, we can't forget that we can have the best mindset. I mean, we could be motivated, ready to go, but if the market, right, if the market isn't in the zone, right, it really doesn't matter what we do, right? So we could be ready all we want. If the market isn't ready, guess what? We'll still have difficulties, okay? So we want to incorporate both. So we want to be in the zone. And then we also, right? We also need to have the market. The market has to be ready, okay? And all we have to do is wait. We just have to wait for the market to be ready. Okay, so the market is not in the zone. Can you guys see the four market phases?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. So here in the accumulation phase, the market is not in the zone. Okay. In the markup phase, the market is in the zone. All right. Three, distribution phase, the market is not in the zone. All right. Fourth phase, the markdown phase, the market is in the zone. Even if it's going down, it's in the markdown phase. It's still in the zone.
It's still in the zone.
Okay. All right. That makes sense. That's pretty cool, right? I think that's cool. Because a lot of times when we talk about the zone, we never really talk about the market. We talk about, you know, just us being in the zone. But the market being in the zone and being ready for us to trade will make a big difference, you know, with trading. All right. So I just wanted to kind of go over that this evening, so that you guys start looking at the markets rather than just, you know, a markup phase, a markdown phase, accumulation and all of that, or buy and sell signals. Look at the market as, hey, is it in the zone? Is it in the zone? Is it ready? Is it ready for me to trade? You know, are these pairs here? We should be back to the trading screen now, right? So are these pairs here ready to trade, right? Compared to these, right? So if these pairs here are in the zone, guess what? We need to be on these pairs here, all right? And then if these pairs here are not in the zone, but they're getting ready over here, we could say, hey, these pairs here, the pound pairs are not in the zone yet. We're gonna wait for them to get in the zone, right? We're gonna be ready for them to get in the zone, and that just makes our job a lot easier. All right. Bitcoin right here, is Bitcoin in the zone? If we look at the price action right here, is it in the zone? Is it in the zone? Right here. You guys see that?
Yes.
Yeah.
So is it in the zone or not?
It's in the zone. So question about Bitcoin.
Okay.
So
there's always a question about Bitcoin. I had so many traders call me up today, Stella.
I know. It kind of moved up today. Yeah. So that was good. So that purple line right there, the lowest purple line price.
Okay.
Maybe like 44, 40, maybe 45 or so.
Okay.
So if it breaks that, I guess that's a support level. Would you call that a resistance or a support level now that it's below the purple line?
Which, right?
The price.
The purple line, this purple line right here?
Yeah. So if it breaks above that, say it breaks above that line. So okay. Would that be breaking support or breaking resistance?
So
because there is no other line. Yes. Under it.
Yes. So so remember, mm-hmm. Support, mm-hmm. support, when the price is on the way down, we have support. Mm-hmm. When the price reverses and come back up, support becomes resistance. So yes, mm-hmm. this is now resistance. So we can draw a resistance here. Right. We can draw a resistance here. Okay, so here would be resistance. Support, we would say support is right here. So this purple line right here was the lowest. So support here. We've got two touches here, a little bit more than two. We can consider this support in here. So we can move it up kind of like here. So that's support right here. So that's support resistance. So what's your question?
So then, so looking at it that way, would we say that, I don't know, because it's still,
I think I know what you're trying to say.
It's on the red side, but it's moving up. So would we say that we're expecting it to keep going up?
I think I know what she's trying to say. Well, I looking at Bitcoin. So right now, since it broke support, Bitcoin is still in red. Right now, it's still in really bad position. But if Bitcoin reaches up and passes and enters that resistance, it's back on the safe zone. It becomes a safe zone now. But I wouldn't trust that Bitcoin is going to go up yet because it's still in the danger zone. Sometimes the buyers try to do a buy, but for the sellers is actually a pullback, and they just do that and then they push it back down more. So the only way it'll be kind of like in a safe zone is if it enters again past the 45 mark.
So the 45,000 here, because this is 45,000 right here. Yeah.
If it passes the 45 and it enters again, I call it, I guess, the safe zone, but still doesn't mean put your money in because it's not trending or it's not in the zone. It's still gonna be safe, but it's not gonna be in the zone.
All right. Anyone else?
I think so.
Okay. Anyone else has an opinion? Anyone else has an opinion? Okay. So what phase is it in? What phase? Because I had lots of traders called me up and say, hey, Dave, you know, Bitcoin made a big move today. Should we be buying? What phase are we in today?
Let me look at my the chart that you gave us. One second.
Okay. What phase are we in?
We're still in the redistribution phase.
Yeah, we're in the redistribution phase. We're in the markdown phase, right? We're in the redistribution phase. We're in the markdown phase. We should not. We are nowhere close to buy.
Okay. I think, Dave, is because sometimes people, because I also have news apps and stuff, and the news apps pops out and goes, you know, Robert Kiyosaki said buy right now, and everybody gets excited and wants to take that advice. But yeah, you're right, it's still in redistribution.
It's in the redistribution phase. It's in the markdown phase. We've got all red candles. This stuff right here will hurt us as traders. It will absolutely hurt us. Okay, not just emotionally, but financially. Okay, let's look here. You see where this price here went all the way up to this moving average here, almost went to resistance. Okay, so look here for a second. Here was support. Okay, here is support, and then the price went from, let's put a number to it. So the price went to 45,000 all the way up to 52,000. You guys see that from here all the way up here?
Yes.
Okay. Guess what? This didn't happen by accident. There was buying that came in. Buying came in to drive the price all the way up here. But guess what? The price is all the way down here. Guess what? It went as low as all the way down here. So should we be buying Bitcoin now?
If you want to tie your money up.
No, but really.
No,
the buyers are not in. The buyers are not in. Bitcoin could easily get back down. All right. This is important. This is important. This is all noise. The move today is all noise. Price doesn't move in a straight line. Look here. It's going to go up. It's going to go down. It's going to go up. It's going to go down. It's going to go up. And you will get fooled by all of this here. Okay. It's not until, right, buyers really come in, breaks resistance, green candles is when we buy. All this right here is just noise. And this is where traders will lose a lot of money. Yeah, they will lose a lot of money here. Yeah, it's still in the markdown phase. Red candles trading below this moving average. And that, this is why we do this, right? This is why we have the system like this, okay? If we didn't have these red candles and we had green and blue or whatever, right? And they were mixed, we couldn't see the real move. We couldn't see the real trend to the downside, right? If you guys didn't have the chart with the four market phases, you wouldn't know that this is in the markdown phase. Even having that information, you guys are still undecided about what price is doing, all right? And there shouldn't be any indecision, right, about what price is doing. It's clear. It's really clear to see what price is doing. And price is in the markdown phase. It's trending down. You will have moves within, just like here, just like in the markup phase, you're going to have pullbacks, right, within the markup phase. But guess what? It's continuing to go up. So if someone came in here, let's take a look at this. So if someone came in here, a trader came in here and said, hey, the price is too high, I'm going to short it, right? The price is too high, I'm going to short it. And they try to short it. Guess what? Look at that. Look at this. Look at what they're trying to short against. They're trying to go against this overall trend, right? So let's say they try to short here. They're going to get kicked out of that trade. They try to short here. They're going to get any time, anywhere in the markup phase, they would have failed. And this is risky to try to short it, right, to the downside while the it's in the markup phase, price is going higher. Boy, don't you guys see that? You guys see what I see? You guys see what I see? Help me out here, guys. Do you guys see what I see?
Yes.
All right. So if you try to short this, if you try to short it here, anywhere in this move, and these are big moves. I mean, it's, you know, you could try to short it, but boy, you won't be very successful shorting it to the downside while it's in the markup phase, price is moving higher. Same thing here.
Mm-hmm.
You can't buy it, right? You can't buy it while it's doing this. Because if you try to buy it, you're going against the trend. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. So this will hurt us as traders. this right here, getting in because of the noise. We call this noise, right? This is all noise, right? All noise. And we know Bitcoin can move, so it could get back down to this area by the end of the week. Yeah, it could get all the way down to this area here. Who knows? We don't know, but we will know. So if at some points it breaks resistance, gets up above this moving average, kind of like here, we see buyers come in, we get a big white candle, big green candle, kind of like here, big white candle, big green candle, then we know, okay, the buyers are in. And don't think we're missing out. We missed the price down here, right? Don't think like that. That, hey, I if I had known, I would have gotten in here. It's all the way up here at 50,000. Man, I wish I, that's not tradable. This is not tradable if you want to go long. This is not tradable. It's not your money. This is not your trade. It's not your money. Yeah, only when it does this, right? The buyers are in. Remember, buy at resistance, sell at support, right? It's only when it's there. That's now, that's your money. That's that you can trade. You can trade that. Here, you're going to be with everyone else. Everyone else. And we don't want to do that, right? We want to trade differently than what the crowd is doing, right? We want to be on the other side of the trade, all right? It's a zero-sum game. So there's always a loser and there's always a winner. There's always a loser. It's a zero-sum game. For every loser, there's a winner, and every winner, there's a loser. Let them lose. Let them lose. Nothing personal. Let them take their losses. If the price gets all the way down here, guess what? It is what it is. If it gets all the way down here, guess what? I'd rather it be someone else than us. Much rather it be someone else than us, right? Let the price do its thing. Let the buyers come in. Like this here to show, hey, they're ready now to buy. I had so many traders call me today. David, Bitcoin made a big move today. What do you think? I don't think anything. There's nothing to think about. Here is the price action right here. Okay. It's in the zone. It's in the zone. But guess what zone is in? It's in the markdown phase. That's the zone. That's the zone. All right. That makes sense. I love watching Bitcoin. I love watching Bitcoin because, hey, it's what's popular right now. It's what's popular right now, but it's got amazing price moves too. It's got amazing price moves. I mean, really nice price moves, right? Clear buying on resistance, clear selling on support, just really nice moves. But we can use this as an example of what to do, but most importantly, what not to do, all right? So there are traders that got in. I always talked about this, right? There are traders that got in here. 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 And there are traders that are getting in here. And they all thought that the price would be going higher, right? They all thought that the price would go higher. That's why they got in. Because they thought the price would go higher. And they're waiting for the price to go higher. It's not what we do. It's not what we do. Okay. So we need confirmation, and we need to wait patiently. As exciting as it is, and I know Bitcoin is exciting and people want to trade it, but as exciting as it is, we have to wait for the buyers to come back in. Right here, right here, right here. All right, guys. Very good. Very good questions. Remember, all right, we have to be in the flow. If we try to trade, I don't care how much we try to be in the flow. You guys heard Ricky many times, and I've done it many times, where you scream at these screens, you cry at these screens, you pray. You get down on your knees and you pray, right? When you're in trades like this, and you absolutely pray that the price please move, go up, and it keeps doing this. And we don't want to be doing that. We don't want to be doing that, right? So we want to wait, wait, wait. And when we'll get green candles, price will break resistance, we'll get a buy signal. Until then, we go shopping, we do something else, go on vacation. All right. Any questions for me, guys? Hope this makes sense. Any questions for me? So what has to be, one more question for you guys. What has to be in the zone? What has to be in the zone for us to be successful?
The market has to be in the zone.
The market has to be in the zone. Great job, Stella. And what else? What else has to be in the zone? Oh, who else has to be in the zone? So the market has to be in the zone, and who else needs to be in the zone?
We need to be in the zone.
We need to be in the zone. Very good. All right, guys. Hey, great class. Thanks for staying up with me, and I'll see you guys tomorrow, okay? Good job. Good job. Good thinking. Take care, guys. Good night.
Good night.